a number on me.
Something's wrong, Mr. Jensen. Brown and his guests are in danger. I no longer have eyes on them.
Marchenko's threatening to blow up hundreds of innocent people next door.
Only hundreds? If Brown and his guests die, billions of augmented people will be stripped of all rights and classified as less than human. You cannot let that future occur, can you?
Why have you not come? Is your faith in hypotheticals truly that strong? Apparently not. You have made the right choice, brother. Why should so many die so loudly when a far more subtle message can be sent? To achieve my mission, I only need Brown and his guests to die. And you, of course. Now show yourself!
I'm taking you down, Victor.
I do not fear death, nor do I revel in it, brother. But for some, I am told that it can be a relief. Tonight, one of us will find out if that is the truth.
So glad you could make it. You're better off now. No more streets. I am so glad you
McCready, bomb threat's neutralized. Marchenko's dead.
First fucking good news I've heard all day. What about Brown and the delegates?
I'm heading to the meeting room now, but chances are it's too late. I'll let you know. Jensen out.
Initiate access granted.
Thank you. Thank you. moving.
Strong foundation with the augmented talking about the foundation basically inevitable. That can't be enough. Some people call this project an artificial utopia, but the parents say you can't have artificiality.
Tune in next week for our second episode of this series, where we will look at the technology of sustainability that the Sandra Group claims to have perfected.
Eliza Kassel,
reporting to you live from
Pegasus. Keeping you alive and clearing the way to you.
Thank you. did that?
Adam, it's me. That pocket secretary in Hong Kong, it went live a few seconds ago, just long enough to shoot out a message.
You intercepted it?
Yeah, but it's cryptic. Looks like meeting in session. Proceed with delivery. Key 2202.
Greedy. I'm too late. They're all dead.
Memorial services are being held around the world today for Santos CEO Nathaniel Brown and several prominent members of the UN Security Council. Brown and his guests were murdered last week when augmented terrorists attacked the Safe Harbor Convention in London. Interpol released chilling images from the murder scene, admitting that the attack could have been much worse. Apparently, members of the Augmented Rights Coalition, infuriated over the death of their leader, also planned to blow up residential towers surrounding the Apex Center Convention Hall. I do not know about you folks, but I think it is high time the United Nations passed the Human Restoration Act, so we can all sleep safe again at night. This is Eliza Kazan, reporting to you.
They're fanning the flames.
From Pikes.
Fanning them? They lit the fucking torch, man. Eliza might as well go door to door handing out pitchforks.
Ark was gonna be blamed no matter what. From the second Brown opened the doors. If he'd listened to me.
Too friggin' arrogant to listen. He gambled big and he lost big for all of us Augs. Damn it. We were so close to pushing that vote back.
We were close to losing thousands of innocent people, too.
Yeah, I know. And thanks to you, we didn't. Hell of a choice you had to make, Adam.
If I could have saved them all, I would have. But sacrificing thousands for a shot at an uncertain future, to me, that's not a choice.
It might have been our best shot at that future. Now we'll have to find a new one. Listen, you know I'm on your side. I'm just pissed because Janus texted me last night, told me the Human Restoration Act has already passed. They're just waiting for Pikus to stir up the mob some more before officially announcing it.
Janus knows that for a fact?
Yeah.
So they got what they wanted.
I'm sure they're feeling pretty good right about now. But this bullshit act, the segregation, the violence, it's just gonna make everything worse.
I know. The task force is gonna be busy.
You're not planning to go back to them, are you?
Wasn't aware I'd left.
But you did your time, man. You already proved that outfit is corrupt. Why stay?
We know what's coming, Alex. The Collective needs all the help it can get. And it's not all smoke and mirrors. The Task Force does make a difference.
Sure, not everyone in the organization is compromised. Just the ones issuing all the orders.
Miller wasn't corrupt. He was a good man, a good cop. Maybe if I'd seen it sooner. My point is, there are others inside the Force we can trust. We just have to find the right people.
Can't say I like this, Adam, but you're the one taking the biggest risk. I feel Janus in. He's been looking for an angle to get us closer to Manderly and Paige.
I'm sure I can find one for him. But when you speak to him, tell him this too. If we're going all the way on this, we need everyone on board, including Janus. I think it's high time we met the man behind the mask, Alex. Don't you?
Law enforcement officials in Prague have tracked down and captured the bomb maker, whose deadly explosive devices claimed the lives of dozens of innocent travelers earlier this week. The woman, an ex-army demolition specialist named Allison Stanek, appears to be a religious fanatic and leader of the tech cult group, Church of the Machine God. Police arrested her and several of her followers inside the cult's headquarters, following an extensive investigation. If you ask me, folks, that is some very good news indeed. A coroner's report released in Prague today offers shocking new insight into the death of Dr. Talis Rucker, former leader of the Augmented Rights Coalition. Apparently, the primary cause of the doctor's death was the exceedingly high level of alcohol found in his system. No other toxins were present, nor were there signs of any suspicious activity. Sources close to Rucker tell me he had been struggling with alcoholism ever since becoming a public figure. I am sure I do not need to remind you folks that the organization he founded, the Augmented Rights Coalition, has been linked to last week's horrifying terror attack in London. It seems not so long ago that Dr. Talis Rucker was on this very program, trying to convince all of us that his Augmented Rights Coalition was a non-violent organization. Today, of course, we are all a little bit wiser. It did not take long for ARC to reveal its true colors once Dr. Rucker was dead. Since last week's attack...
That is not the point. You should have all been informed.
That is why we are here now.
Volkart, what's done is done. The broad strokes of the operation were very clear and haven't changed. There are always adjustments that will occur in the field. You should know that.
Adjustments?
Those were not mere adjustments.
Interpol was more capable than we anticipated. They have a new augmented agent by the name of...
Adam Jensen.
Who we believe may have had external help. Possibly by the Juggernaut Collective, or even Janus directly.
We're looking into it, but we...
All that is speculation at this point. Let's find out more and reconvene later this week. Thank you, everyone. That'll be all.
It's your own fault.
I'm aware of that, Doctor.
Elizabeth sends her regards.
Report.
Overall, the subject seems quite well adjusted despite the massive traumas he's experienced. And his memories are still consistent with the program. He is remarkably stable.
Excellent. How close is he to contact with Janus?
Very.
It's only a matter of time.